As the flight date approaches, SpaceX continues to fascinate space enthusiasts with their ever-changing plans. The main gun of the flight, Booster 7, has been lifted off the orbital launch mount after the ship quick disconnect arm retracted. On Friday, the pad cleared and the arms made their way up the tower. In moments, they had closed in on Booster 7. Yes, weird, right? Once again, the booster was being lifted off of the orbital launch mount. Something new to see here are these. SpaceX seems to be using these covers now that fully protect the nozzles of the engines. At least the outer Raptor Boost engines. Protection here from the salty ocean air, and a load of orbital launch mount work, is the reason for that. The center engines do still seem exposed given that their engine numbers are visible. But yes, there we have it, Booster 7 is back on its transport stand. I didn't think we would be seeing this again. So why is it back down? Speculation, but I suspect that SpaceX is simply needing better access to work on some of the internal hardware near the launch clamps while completing the installation of the shielding. The answer to where Booster 7 was heading to may already be clear. Elon Musk mentioned that their ultimate goal is to use these arms to catch Starship and Super Heavy out of midair. However, right now they are being used as a more complex alternative to a crane for lifting and removing Starship stages. As for Booster 7, without any official information, it's impossible to determine why it was taken off, but some believe it could be due to modifications inside, or a demonstration of rapidly stacking both stages for launching. Furthermore, installation teams are also installing shields around the booster quick disconnect mechanism and around exposed components on the orbital launch mount, such as manifolds and control panels, in order to protect them from engine exhaust and debris during liftoff. So last week at Starbase, we left off with the huge progress on the orbital launch mount shielding. I'd say with the completion of it getting quite close now. In fact, it's probably a good time to explain how exactly I think SpaceX has designed it and what the future plans might be. At this point, I'm sure you've seen all of the big panels by now, with some slight variations here and there, such as the panels with the doors. And there's also some variations built in to allow the shielding to go around the top of the stairway. Those with hawk-like eyes may have already spotted this. There are still quite big gaps between them. There is already a plan for those gaps, because SpaceX is going to fully cover those up as well. On the top here, they've been hard at work installing plates to go on the outside. That does still leave the side, which they are also covering up, but this time instead with plates on the inside. If I had to guess why, I'd say they have chosen to do this, simply due to the fact that it is a lot easier to access from the inside, compared to having to do it with the external lifts on the exterior. Now, what about future shielding? Speculative maybe, but just take a look at the metal framework installed here, between one of the orbital launch mount legs and the mount itself. That too was recently installed, and I think we'll see this shielding further continue, to eventually encompass all of the cryogenic lines. So in general, you might think right now that activity has slowed. I think instead what we are seeing is the calm before the storm. Think of all the preparation that is needed to prepare to fly. Double and triple checking everything to ensure the largest rocket ever created has the best chance of lifting off, and finally becoming the largest ever human-made rocket to ever leave the ground. You can see here that they've already started with painting the orbital launch mount again, giving it all a fresh coat after that 31 engine static fire weeks ago. We should see this paint covering all of the exposed metal surfaces. And that, I'm sure, is going to include all of those new shields once they have finished being welded. It has been a little while since I've updated you on the suspected water deluge system. Right next to the orbital launch mount here, SpaceX has been hard at work. It looks like we won't see a Starship flight this month anymore, according to Musk's confirmation. But hopefully by April we'll get our first attempt at reaching orbit, even though Musk only believes there's a 50% chance of success. It's now been 18 months since a Starship prototype last flew as part of high-altitude tests beginning in 2021, so let's hope that soon we'll be able to extend life beyond Earth with a fully and rapidly reusable orbital rocket. The Starship project is the embodiment of this vision. For Elon Musk, the first orbital flight of Starship is critical. It will be the first time the rocket is tested in an environment similar to the one it will experience on a mission to Mars. The success of this flight will prove that the rocket is capable of carrying humans and cargo to space and back safely. Moreover, SpaceX has invested a significant amount of money and resources into the development of the Starship. The first orbital flight will be the culmination of years of hard work and dedication. A successful flight will be a significant milestone for the company, and it will cement SpaceX's position as a leader in the space industry. The first Starship orbital flight tests the performance of the rocket's engines and other systems during launch. Once in orbit, the Starship will need to perform various maneuvers, such as adjusting its trajectory and speed, in order to perform its mission. The first orbital flight will test the Starship's maneuverability in space, and provide data on how well it performs in this environment. The Starship's ability to perform a controlled re-entry and landing is crucial for its reusability. The first orbital flight will provide data on how well the Starship performs during re-entry and landing, including how well it handles the heat generated during re-entry. During re-entry, the Starship's heat shield will be tested to see how well it performs in protecting the rocket and its contents from the intense heat generated during re-entry. The flight will provide valuable data on the performance of the heat shield, which will be used to improve it for future missions. The Starship's fuel efficiency is critical for its ability to carry humans and cargo to space and back. The first orbital flight will provide data on the Starship's fuel efficiency during launch, orbit, and re-entry, which will be used to optimize its performance for future missions. Clearly, this flight is considered to be a huge new development step for the company. The orbital flight is the first time that SpaceX has produced a full-size prototype, with two integrated parts together. Starship and Super Heavy will be nearly 120 meters tall, when stacked for launch. It's the largest monster on the planet ever built, simultaneously with this mission. Unlike the flight test, the altitude is only about 10 kilometers above sea level at current. Landship 24 and Super Heavy Booster 7 will make the longest flight ever. It will fly out of Earth's orbit, flying 3/4 of the way around the Earth. Because this is the longest flight, the flight time is the longest as well. This is a flight that's considered a new leap for SpaceX. Second, the Starship's first orbital test flight, though audacious in scale. SpaceX intends to collect as much data as possible during flight to quantify entry dynamics and better understand what the vehicle experiences in a flight regime, and that's extremely difficult to accurately predict or replicate computationally. This data will anchor any changes in vehicle design or conception of operations after the first flight and build better models for them to use in internal simulation. Third, this orbital flight will help SpaceX solidify its lead in the space race. Previously, people knew that SpaceX was famous for its Falcon 9, which is a partially reusable rocket that has saved a lot of money and time for the company with every launch. However, seeing some limitations that Falcon 9 could not bring to the company. If Starship succeeds, SpaceX would further solidify its lead in the space race.